the nurse comes there.
What do you want?
I'll go down below, keep the little one in here, right?
Okay. Jim, what was the other story you were telling me when we were in Mother McHugh's? You had me in stitches.
We were in
Mother McHugh's having the Guinnesses that night. And you told me that story about something that happened in England about one of the guys. And I came out of
when I was going home,
yeah.
It was the first time. Yeah. I
didn't know that.
Went to England with half crown in my pocket. I tell you before.
Yeah, I remember that.
With a half crown in my pocket. Granny Flynn gave to me the half crown. And the week what I was going, Larry and myself got a job from Bradley.
Oh yeah, the
metal.
To
do a bit of work.
Scrap
and
metal.
We got five shilling each, you see. So I give Mummy half a crown, and the other half crown I must go get my photo taken for the travel documents.
Yeah.
And when I going to say goodbye for to Minnie and Granny Flynn, she gave me half a crown. And that's all the money I had. Anyway, I was the Bevan boy, that's what they called, because
yeah.
I think was an hour in Bevan. Was the minister for works and that. And there was on at that time, that in March 1948, the control of works order. You could not leave your job. And you know what I mean? Without permission, you could not do that. If you work in the mine, you could not leave the mine. If you were in munitions and that, you must have. There were exceptions, you understand? And you had to go for the exception if you could do it. Like for instance, if you got in claustrophobia, things like that. But you could not leave your job without permission. And you must have another job. And if you were in the hostel, if you leave your job, you must also leave the hostel. Anyway, the time came around when I am a year there, and I am entitled for to go home. About 2 week holidays when the mine closed down. So they give to you a voucher for the train and the boat and that, because the Great Western coming up the river to Waterford, belonging to the Great Western Railway. And so you are go from Doncaster to London, but to go to from London to Fishguard,
yeah.
It's a big loop, you know what I mean? But it was only way you could go. You must change stations. So I change stations, and I go up to the fellow in the ticket office and say to him, what time the boat train going leaving for to get to Fishguard? You see? And I want to catch the Western to going home. And he says, it's 4 o'clock tomorrow afternoon. And I says, oh no, you don't fool me like that. I says, I'm born in Waterford, I says, and I can always watch for the Great Western coming up the river, and she's coming up the river every Tuesday, Thursday and Saturday, I said, and today's Tuesday, so she's going to come up today, so you can't make fool for me. And he says to me, oh, that's right, Paddy, he says, but you are in England now, he says, and the boat goes every Monday, Wednesday and Friday for to get there, because it was a 12-hour run.
Yeah.
I must stay in London for